Hey, I'm Dakota with the Arclight Dynamics tech team, and today I'm going to show you how to use the pipe cutter on the Flashcut CNC system. We've attached our torch onto our collision detection mount using this 90 degree bracket. From here we have this relocation bracket to move the other end of our collision detection system to where we need it over our pipe. We've mounted our pipe cutter using the two slots on the inside of the gantry on each side, where we run our two bolts in there to lock it in place. We've mounted our pipe inside the pipe cutter, and we've made sure to tighten up our bearings so we're getting good equal contact as the pipe is rotating through them. We've also set the belt tension for our pipe using just a little bit more than the weight of the motor. And so when I'm going down here, I'm just pushing on this motor just a little bit and tightening the bolts that hold it into the bracket, setting this belt tension around the pipe. So that way, when we're getting movement, it's gonna rotate the pipe. We're also going to mount our ground onto the end of the pipe here. So you're gonna get this cable. This is what you're gonna attach your clamp onto and magnet to the inside of the pipe. And then we need to set the configuration for our machine to run the pipe cutter. So that's by going up here to these gears icon called the configuration, hitting load at the top, and selecting our pipe cutter setup. Then we'll save this to move on from here. And now we're set up to run our pipe cutter. We're gonna start by setting up our table to run the pipe cutter with the diameter of pipe we're using today. So we're gonna start by going into CNC, connecting the controller, and then we're gonna home the table. So we're gonna set the circumference of our pipe in our configuration, so we need to move the torch over to the end of our pipe and lower the torch down to where we can reference it. I'm gonna take a Sharpie and mark where the torch is on this pipe. I'm gonna tell it to rotate the pipe 360 degrees. And I'm gonna ensure that this mark I've put on the pipe here will be back at the same point after I've told it to go 360 degrees. To do that, I'm going to go down to this little hamburger button here, hit move to point, change it from program to incremental, and just tell it to move the A axis 360 degrees. Great, and for a little off, we'll need to go in and make adjustments in our configuration. So to do that, we're gonna go into that configuration. We're gonna go to drive parameters. We're gonna select our A axis, edit drive mechanism. Then we're gonna hit calibrate. And we're gonna tell it the measured distance versus the commanded distance. So since we're running 3-inch diameter pipe, we know that our circumference is 9.42 inches. So we have commanded it to go 9.42 inches when we've told it to go 360 degrees. Then the measured distance is how far we're off. So if we're short, we need to calculate maybe we went 9 inches. Then we'll put 9 inches in here, and we can hit calculate, and it will then change the rotation to match the circumference of our pipe. We can hit okay, and we can hit save when we're done. Once we've got our rotation set on our pipe to where it's following 360 degrees, we'll then need to make sure and verify the diameter of our pipe using a set of calipers and the wall thickness of our pipe. We verified the diameter of our pipe as well as the wall thickness. So from here, we can go into CAD and start setting up our drawing. To start our drawing, we're gonna go to File and New and select a pipe/tube part. The first part we're gonna go in is setting that diameter and that wall thickness. We can also set the total length of cut we want to set for this job. In this case, we're going to do about a 5-inch cut. Then from here, if we're wanting to set up branches or headers for this pipe, then we can do a pipe joint or shape tool. And we can tell it whether we're going to be using a branch or a header. In this case, we'll just do a branch, and we'll do a 90 degree tilt on that. We can also set off our axes and our tilt, and we can approve that. Once we've got that approved, we can also set the other side. In this case, I've just got a flat end, so we can actually hit the X on this if we don't want to set another side on this, and that will give us a flat end with a 90 degree attachment. Now from here, we can send this over into cam. This isn't going to be a whole lot different than when we're using plate cutting for plasma. So we're still going to go in and check our job settings and make sure that we have our power max selected. Then we'll select our material settings. And we're using mild steel in this case, and we've told it the wall thickness or the thickness of the plate that we're going to be cutting already in CAD. So we can approve this. And we can go into our plasma settings next and make sure we have our consumables set to what we're cutting. In this case, we're using a 45 amp shielded consumable. And we can approve this. I like to set my origin of the cut to the far right, which will be these little crosshairs at the bottom here. That way we can set the torch on the far end of our pipe and run our job from the far right side. Once we're all set here, we can run it over into CNC, and we're ready to start cutting our pipe. After we finish cutting, give it a couple moments to cool. This pipe will be very hot because we're not cutting in water anymore. Then after that's cooled, we're good to move on to our next cut. This is a basic tutorial on how to use our Arclight pipe cutter with our Flashcut CNC system. Thanks for watching.